reading, Dr. Vedant. I will dissect the heart today. And first, I will go through anatomy, normal anatomy of heart. Then I will dissect through inflow-outflow method. Okay. Heart is a hollow muscular organ, lies in middle mediastinum. And position of heart is downward, forward and towards left. You have to keep heart in thumb and forefingers. So this is normal anatomical position of heart. It's called apex, part of left ventricle from the apex of heart, and this is called base of heart. All major blood vessels like aorta and pulmonary trunk forms the base of heart. And on normal borders of heart, heart is superior border, which is formed by these all blood vessels, and this apex of heart is formed by left ventricle and part of right ventricle. Inferior border of heart is formed by right ventricle, left border of heart is formed by left ventricle and part of left auricle. Right border of heart is formed by right atrium. First we have to look the surface of heart. Here we can see these grayish white patches. These are patches of old pericarditis, which is called shoulder spot or McCallum patches. You can see these whitish patches. These are called shoulder spot. Possibly also we can see here, somewhere here, some small grayish white patch we can see. So how to identify which is anterior surface and which is posterior surface? You have to look for aorta, which always faces over left side. So here I am holding the heart, and now aorta is always facing left side. So this is anterior surface and this is posterior surface. And towards my right, it's the right side of heart, here left side of heart. So now we'll identify normal structures in heart. This is aorta. In front of aorta, this is pulmonary trunk. Pulmonary trunk, two branches, left pulmonary artery and the right pulmonary artery. Towards right side here, we have right atrium, say right auricle, and here lower down is right ventricle. Two openings are there in right atrium, which is superior and inferior vena cava. So you have to pass this forceps. Inferior opening is called inferior vena cava. Superior opening is called superior vena cava. Now towards left side, we have this chamber. This is called left atrium. Small auricle like thing is left auricle. Downward is left ventricle. Four openings are there in left atrium, which are called opening of pulmonary veins. Right two side, two openings, left two openings of pulmonary veins. You can see one, two, three, four. These all are pulmonary veins openings. So there are many methods of dissection of heart. Most common is inflow-outflow technique, which we dissect the heart according to direction of blood flow. Other techniques are short axis method, long axis method, four chamber method, window technique, Fulton's technique. So now I will dissect the heart according to direction of blood flow. Pass the forceps from inferior vena cava to superior vena cava and cut the connection. I can also go from inferior vena cava through right auricle if I want to preserve the SA node. SA node lies at the junction of superior vena cava and right atrium. Keep it there. Should I cut
cut the junction of superior and inferior neck cable and expose the vertebrae.
Chamber is right atrium. Try to identify normal structures of right atrium. This depression like thing is called fossa ovalis, and this upper border is called limbus fossa ovalis. Posteriorly, one opening is there, which is called opening of coronary sinus. This opening. Of coronary sinus. Many small veins of heart opens in coronary sinus. This is a large vein. Here anterior surface, these are called pectinate muscles. And this border is called crista terminalis. And these small openings we can see, these are openings of small veins of heart, like middle cardiac vein, great cardiac vein, small cardiac vein, unicardius minimi, tibial nerves and all. So now I will give one extra incision to right auricle to look for any thrombus. Right auricle is triangular in shape. Now I'll try to identify SA node and AV node. SA node lies at the junction of superior vena cava and right atrium. So somewhere here, this is junction. We cannot see SA node through naked eye gross exam. So we have to take 2x2 cm block from this junction. We have to look at the microscope. Again, I'll go to right ventricle. First, while going through right ventricle, we have to pass 3 fingers to look for any tricuspid stenosis or any thickening. So here it's passing 3 fingers, it's normal. So now I will go through right border of heart and enter the right ventricle. Ideally we have to dissect heart through anterior dome, but I am dissecting through this normal seizure. Cut the apex. So now we'll try to identify the AV node. The landmark of the AV node is called Cox triangle. Cox triangle is formed superiorly by tendon of Cordaro, inferiorly by opening of coronary sinus, and apex is formed by septal leaflet of tricuspid wall. So how to identify tendon of Cordaro? You have to pull the wall of right atrium backward, and some elevated area we can see here, where here it's called tendon of Cordaro. So opening of coronary sinus. And here septal leaflet of tricuspid wall. You have to take 2x2 cm block from this area and look at the microscope to identify the AV node. It's called Cox triangle. So in right ventricle, we'll try to identify the structures. These are called trabeculations. This is papillary muscle. These are called chordae tendinae, thread-like thing, chordae tendinae, and these are valve cusp, anterior, posterior, and septal. Tricuspid valve has 3 cusps, anterior, posterior, and septal. We have to pass fingers and try to feel if there is any growth, vegetations, calcifications. Here it looks normal. We have to measure the circumference of walls also. Ideally, we have to measure through graduated cones before going through right ventricle. But can also measure with the thread.
Measure like this. Here is coming 12 centimeter. Normal circumference of tricuspid valve is 10 to 12 centimeter. So here it is normal.
Then we have to measure the thickness of right ventricle free wall.
We have to measure the thickness 1 centimeter below the attachment of wall cusp.
So here 1 centimeter below. Here we have to measure the thickness. Coming around 5 millimeter or 0.5 centimeter. We have to exclude this fat layer also and this trabeculation or capillary muscle layer. Normal thickness of right ventricle free wall is 3 to 5 millimeter or 0.3 to 0.5 centimeter. We have to also look for any septal defect in atrium or ventricle. Here it looks normal, no septal defect. And there is no impact in ventricle free wall. No impacted area, gray white area or hemorrhagic patch, nothing is there. I will go from right ventricle to pulmonary tract. Anterior interventricular group, we have to dissect 1 centimeter lateral to anterior interventricular group and enter the pulmonary tract. No. Two branches. Now we have opened the pulmonary trunk. Here we can see the valve. These are pulmonary valve cusps. Pulmonary valve is semilunar valve. It has three cusps, 1, 2, 3. Now we have to check the patency of this valve to pour some water and see whether these valve cusps are holding water or not. So now these valve cusps are holding water. That means these valves are competent. Functioning normally. You have to also feel these valves to look for any growth, vegetations or calcifications. Here it looks normal. And other valve structures you can see, this middle one is nodule like thing, is called nodule. And it's here both side nodules, middle thing is nodule. And pronodule surrounding this semilunar shape thing is called lunule. Other pulmonary trunk looks normal. All is normal. So from pulmonary trunk blood goes to lungs. Lungs purifies the blood, and from lungs through pulmonary veins blood goes to left side of heart to left ventricle. So we'll turn the heart to left side. Try to identify all four pulmonary veins opening, and we have to open these pulmonary veins, then we will enter in right atrium. There is technique of opening these pulmonary veins. First we have to cut right and left upper pulmonary veins, then on both sides upper and lower pulmonary veins. Thank you.
Now we have opened. Left atrium.
You can see structures. Left atrium somewhat smooth than right atrium. You can see. So there is no septal defect. Looks normal. Now we'll give one extra incision to left auricle to look for any neural thrombus. The difference between right auricle and left auricle: right auricle is triangular in shape, left auricle is somewhat quadrangular in shape. Left auricle. There is no thrombus. Looks normal. Now we have to look the opening of this metal wall. So to pass two fingers whether they are passing or not. In case of metal stenosis, we are not able to pass two fingers in this wall. So here it looks normal. So now we enter the left ventricle through the lateral border of heart. Normal thickness of these both right atrium and left atrium is 1 to 2 millimeter. For that I forgot to measure the circumference of pulmonary wall. So same method, take thread, measure the circumference. It's coming around 7.5 centimeter. Normal circumference of pulmonary wall is 7 to 9 centimeter. Now I will enter the left ventricle through the lateral border of heart. Cut till the apex. This is left ventricle chamber. Here we can see these all are trabeculations. They are papillary muscles, chordae tendineae and wall cusp. Metal valve has only two cusps, one here, this is anterior, that is posterior. So to feel these walls, to look for any vegetation, growth or calcification or fibrosis, here it looks normal. And we saw the papillary muscle or right side, right ventricle and left side. Left side ventricle papillary muscles are somewhat thicker than right.
So the papillary muscles.
They are called papillary muscles. Yeah. I will measure the circumference of metal wall. Normal circumference of metal valve is 8 to 10.5 cm. Now we have to measure the thickness of left ventricle free wall. Same idea, we have 1 cm below the attachment of wall cusp, we have to measure the thickness and we have to exclude this fat layer and this papillary muscle layer. Coming around 1.4 cm. Normal thickness of left ventricle free wall is 1 to 1.5 cm or 10 to 15 mm. You have to also look this left ventricle muscle to look for any fibrosis, grey white areas which shows recent or old infarct or any calcification. Nothing is there, it looks normal. From left ventricle blood goes to aorta, pass the fossa from left ventricle to aorta. We can also dissect this heart to anterior border of heart
or you can directly cut this metal wall first and cut the aorta. If I don't want to preserve this metal wall, I will go through the metal wall only and cut this, because later it will help in tracing the coronaries only. So I have cut the aorta. So these are called aortic walls. Aortic wall is also a semilunar wall. It has three cusps, 1, 2, 3. Means same thing, you have to pour some water and look for competency of these walls. Walls are holding some water, so these are competent. There is no calcification, no thickening, nothing in there. Now we have to measure the circumference of the aortic wall. Normal circumference of aortic wall is 6 to 7.5 cm. So, we'll see this aorta. There are some thickening, there some elevated yellowish area we can see. These are called atheromatous plaques. You can feel this hard thing. They're called atheromatous plaques. Here also we can see atheromatous plaques. There are openings in aorta, ascending aorta. These are called coronary ostium. Left side is called left sinus of Valsalva. Middle, this is called right sinus of Valsalva. So this opening is for left coronary ostium, this is right coronary ostium. So left coronary ostium is opening for left coronary artery, and right coronary ostium is opening for right coronary artery. So we can name this wall cusp according to opening of the coronary ostium. So this is called left coronary cusp, this is called right coronary cusp, and there is no opening, this is called non-coronary cusp. So we have to check the opening also, is there any thickening or stenosis, so it can stop the flow of blood. Block the flow of blood.
No, ostium is blocked in
syphilis. Syphilis also. In this right coronary, right sinus of Valsalva, we can see two small openings. This is one abnormality of heart. Normally there is only one opening. So this is some common anomaly we can see in normal people, not a major issue. So now I'll trace the coronaries. Put the finger on this left coronary ostium on our anterior surface. And I will give serial sections at a distance of 2 to 3 mm and try to look for any thrombus which can block the flow of blood and should lead to myocardial infarction or ischemia. We have to give incision as close to aorta as possible, first incision. So, see, opening of left main coronary artery. So, here it looks patent, somewhat thickening is there, but lumen is patent. So, after 1 or 2.2 millimeter distance, it will give two branches. One is called left anterior descending artery, which runs over anterior interventricular groove and is surface of heart, and other is called left circumflex artery, which runs in left AV groove or left side of heart. Now we'll trace the coronaries. You have to give one single incision, not 2-3 incisions, because we might dislodge the thrombus. There are many techniques of opening this coronaries. We can also take small seizure and open the coronaries longitudinally, or through this method transverse section.
longitudinal method, there is disadvantage that we might dislodge the thrombus, so we may not be able to identify the thrombus. So in transverse section, we can also see the lumen, patency of lumen, how much it blocked. So it looks somewhat thickened, but lumen is patent. Here it is divided in two branches, you can see two openings. This opening is opening for left anterior descending artery, and this one is for left circumflex artery. Now we trace the left anterior descending artery. Two openings. One more opening here, we can see this is one collateral of left anterior descending artery. Collateral. This is main left anterior descending artery. Here we can see this coronary is very thickened. Lumen is patent or 70% patent, 30% narrow. Here we can see atherosclerotic change in left anterior descending artery. Lumen is somewhat 40% narrow. Getting narrowed. So we have to trace this left anterior descending artery till the apex of heart. We have to also see the course of this coronary artery. So we saw here this left anterior descending artery is running in fat layer, epicardial layer. Then if I go down, it will dip in myocardium. It's a normal phenomenon. One phenomena is called myocardial bridging, in which this left anterior descending artery, but first it will run in the epicardial layer, again in middle segment it dips in myocardium, and distally again it will come in epicardium. So that middle part is bridged. So when heart will contact this middle segment, gets collapsed. So it can originate arrhythmia. Sometimes distal ischemia it can cause, but in most cases heart blood flows in diastole, so it will not cause a problem. But in case of demand is more, person is doing exercise, so heart blood demand is more, so in that case myocardial supply is less, demand is more, so it can cause ischemia and it can originate arrhythmia, and person can die suddenly, can cause sudden death. So myocardial bridging is also one of cause of sudden death. So normally 90% dies at rest. So human should be at least 90% narrow. In case of exercise, it should be at least 75% narrow. It's called critical narrowing of coronary artery. Now we'll test the left circumflex artery, left AV group. Okay. This is left circumflex artery. That looks patent. Wall is thickened, but lumen is patent. depth circumflex arteries thin walled as compared to depth main anterior descending artery, right coronary artery. So now we'll test the right coronary artery.
Let's continue.
Circumflex. Test the right coronary artery. So originating from right coronary ostium. Mainly right coronary artery is longest artery. Its length is 12 to 14. And trace the right coronary artery. Right coronary artery after originating gives one branch over right border of heart. It's called right marginal artery. And here it runs posteriorly and gives one branch. It's called posterior interventricular artery. In 70% cases, this posterior interventricular branch is given by right coronary artery and we call heart is right dominant. 10% cases, this posterior interventricular branch is given by left circumflex artery and we call it heart is left dominant. 20% cases, this posterior interventricular branch is a branch of both left circumflex and right coronary artery. Then we call heart is co-dominant. So I'll trace the right coronary artery. Put one finger over right coronary ostium. It runs in right AV groove, so right side fat is more, so we have to first give broad incision. Try to identify the right coronary. This right coronary artery also somewhat thickened, but lumen is patent. Again we have to give serial sections at 2 to 3 mm distance. Again lumen is patent. Human is patent. Posterior knee. Yeah. Getting thinner. And go to posterior side. Smaller. Then if we want to see the interventricular septum, then we can give transverse section from FX to look for any impacted area or thickening of interventricular septum. And you can see it looks normal, no gray white areas, no calcification, no infarct. Or we can open like this longitudinal method. We have to measure the thickness of interventricular septum also. Normally thickness of interventricular septum is same as left ventricle free wall. Here it is around 1.4 cm. In case of hypertrophic obstructive cardiomyopathy, asymmetric enlargement, asymmetric hypertrophy of interventricular septum as compared to left ventricle free wall. Now after dissection of heart, you have to weigh the heart. Normal weight of heart is 250 to 300 grams, 250 grams in case of females. In males is around 300 grams. Other, sorry. Okay. We should weigh the heart after dissection only, not before the dissection, because there are postmortem blood clots, which are called red currant jelly and chicken fat blood clots. That may increase the weight of heart. So after dissection, after thorough washing, we you have to weigh the heart, so it can give correctly the weight of heart. And the hypertrophy, we can there is grading mild, moderate and severe. Up to 25% increase in weight of heart is normal. 25 to 50% is called mild hypertrophy. 50 to 100% is called moderate hypertrophy. 100 to 200% increase in weight of heart is called severe hypertrophy.
Thank you.